Well, good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Nature Live here at the Natural History Museum. My name's Aoife, and I shall be your host for today's event. I'd also like to welcome now our online audience. And just to remind you guys watching online, if you've got any questions you want to ask at any point during the event, click on the link below the screen, email them into us, and we'll do our best to get through them during today's event. And of course, to our studio audience, for those of you who've just joined us, if you've got any questions, pop your hand up. I'll sprint over to you with the microphone, and you can ask away. Now, we're joined today by, we've got two speakers today for you. We've got Andrew Parker from the zoology department, and also Franziska Schenk, who is an artist, and we're going to be talking about fluctuating colour in nature and art. We have some fantastic things for you to have a look at. But first of all, can I find out from both of you a little bit more about what you do, what your area of interest is? Andrew, you first.
Yes, well, I explore the diversity of colour that we find in nature. At first sight, you might think everything is down to pigments, the same thing as we find in our clothes, for example. But in fact, there are seven different ways of producing colour in nature. Pigments, of course, is perhaps the most common. But another one of those is structural colour, and that's the subject we're going to explore today. This is where we have completely transparent structures that produce some of the brightest effects that you find in nature. So some of the bright metallic hummingbirds and beetles, for example. You often get an effect called iridescence, a bit like a prism in a way, the way a prism splits light into a spectrum. We don't actually find prisms in nature, but we do find a whole range of alternatives. And that's what I look at, that's what I do my research on here at the museum, and it's something we're going to be talking about today.
So we'll find out exactly how that works, try and get our head around that idea. And Franziska, could you tell us what your area of...
Yeah, is? Andrew will explain all the ins and outs of the mechanisms of iridescence, but I'm, as an artist, I'm more interested in the application of latest pigments that have been developed with nature in mind, some very closely resembling structures found in nature. It's quite a new technology and not that easy and straightforward to apply. As they are found in animals, I'm therefore looking at particular specimens. I'm looking at how does the animal actually utilize these iridescent colors, how do they produce them, and what can I learn from that.
You're both approaching colour from slightly different perspectives, but your work has come together in this particular field that we're going to be finding out a little bit more in just a second.